To come save you.
I finished synthesizing. Ingest this pill, then go and find the source of the mold. Only there can we begin to understand how to stop it.
So you promise I won't end up walking around covered in mold?
Ugh, the pill will prevent any biological infection by the mold.
Take a mystery pill because a rude lady in a hazmat suit tells you to. Great idea, Jesse.
Ugh. Honestly, did you want me to wrap it in cheese?
Not the taste, the smell. It stinks in here now.
Good. That means the pill is working. The worse it smells, the safer you'll be. Now go. Find the source.
Have you worked with Emily Pope?
Our paths have crossed. Darling arranged for us to have a coffee. A meeting of the minds, he called it. She's talented. I can certainly see her doing well here.
I feel like there's a but coming.
But she's drunk a bit too much of the Bureau's proverbial Kool-Aid. She shouldn't be afraid to forge ahead on her own. Science is skepticism. Everything must be questioned before the truth can emerge.
So is Darling your boss?
If you insist on clinging to such outdated hierarchies, then yes. However, I would argue that our fields are too dissimilar for one to manage the other. Of course, Darling would much prefer to find his own miracle solution to the Bureau's fungal frustrations. He always needs to be the hero.
So tell me again how you came to work at the Bureau.
Well, like I said, I was brought in as a special advisor. A temporary position, you see. Although that's not the whole truth. I was employed here for a time, straight out of university. After a decade of admittedly fascinating work in threshold research and regulation, I began to chafe under the bureaucracy. I needed a change. Not that academia was so different.
And then the mold happened.
About 4 months ago, yes. Since my departure from the Bureau, they hadn't been able to find my equal in threshold analysis. Darling and I had kept in touch over the years, meeting at conferences and the like. He called me, and I booked a flight. I've never been able to say no to a man with a dangerous alien biosphere. I had to leave my post in the middle of term, but so be it.
So she's a professor. That explains a lot.
The mold seems to be having some weird effects on things.
Indeed. Even people are susceptible. The fungus grows rapidly within the chest cavity, killing the host. Luckily, one must ingest the stalks to become infected.
Don't eat the mold. Okay.
We've always cremated the infected bodies after autopsy, but I believe there may be another stage of maturity. A blooming, if you will.
I never thought the word blooming would sound so horrible.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure.
Be careful down there. We don't want to have to come save you.
This must be the pit Underhill was talking about.
Captain Lopez, reporting on Expedition 17B. At the formation now, visually no distinction from the previous visit. The link detectors are still standing. One arch has a light flashing, so we're gonna give the area once over. Then we'll head back. Lopez out.
Oh God, the further I go, the worse it smells.
Dead? These things killed them all.
Hey, you're inside of my door.
There are so many. You're listening. Get out. No! Push away!
Is that the source? It's kind of pretty.
Nope. Not.
Thank you.
Is that the source? It's kind of pretty.
Nope. Not pretty.
Is that the source? It's kind of pretty.
Thank you.
Is that the source? It's... kind of scary.
Nope.
Yeah.
Is that the source? It's kind of pretty.
Nope. Not.